Welcome, everybody, to Van Noort Arena, home of the Calvin Knights. Tonight, we see the Alma Scots taking on your Calvin Knights. My name's Ryan Schumer. I'm a freshman here on the baseball team, joined here by my partner in crime, Ryan Shearhart. How are we doing on this beautiful Saturday afternoon in Grand Rapids, Ryan?
You know, Ryan, I'm doing fantastic. It's great to be back in Van Noort Arena. You know, coming off of that big win here at home in Van Noort Arena earlier against Hope.
Yeah, what an energy here in Van Noort Arena. Never seen an arena that powerful here. I mean, the whole lower bowl filled with 1,000-plus students here and just unreal energy here in Van Noort Arena, really propelling the team to victory and a huge win in the conference.
You know, and that's the game, right? As a student athlete, when you step and put on a Calvin uniform, that is the game. That's the game you prepare for, is playing Hope and defending that home territory in the rivalry game. And the Knights were able to defend the home floor quite well. And Knight Nation put on a show as well. Just a lot of fun and a great atmosphere. And really just what Calvin Athletics was all about represented there.
Yeah, a lot of notables from that game. Uchenna Ekekeza hitting his 1,000th career point on that huge slam dunk over here on this end of the court. Just a huge, really turned. Knight's still up in that game, but a big momentum change there as Hope starting to come back into that one. Uchenna Ekekeza just with a huge two-handed slam, really putting it away here for the Knights. And huge game for a few players. We had Owen Varnado, Uchenna Ekekeza, Jalen Overway, and Jordan Scott, all with 10-plus points. Jordan Scott, huge impact freshman here for the Knights.
Yeah, and you know, Jordan Scott has just been such a good talent, you know, a highly recruited guy for the Knights that really wanted to get him, you know, in the maroon and gold, and he's done nothing shy of, but just been fantastic for this Knights squad and playing above his freshman class, and he's just so good, such a bright future for him. And you know, with how you mentioned Uchenna Ekekeza getting that 1,000-point milestone, you know, probably a sigh of relief there a little bit to be so close and then finally, you know, get it on an emphatic slam. That was really a momentum shifter for him. So congratulations to him and just a testament to the career he's had as a Calvin Knight and how he's represented the maroon and gold.
Yeah, what a way to get that 1,000-point mark tonight. The Knights take on the Alma Scots. Alma Scots 8-8 this year, 2-3 in the conference. Really something to prove here tonight. Going against the number 4 ranked in the nation Knights. Currently sitting at number 1 in the MIAA. Huge game here for the Scots, and the Knights really just defending that undefeated MIAA record and continuing to climb those national rankings here tonight.
Yeah, and you know, these next 3 games for the Knights, obviously the Hope game included in that 3-game stretch I'm talking about, but playing Hope, who's number 3 in conference. Coming up after this one, they'll play Trine, who's number 2 in conference, and the Scots, the 4 in conference, you know, battle with the top 4 teams in the conference in the MIAA. So some really big games here for the Knights, and a big game here at home on this weekend, Saturday, against the Alma Scots to claim that MIAA title.
Yeah, both teams coming off the floor right now, getting ready for warm-ups, about a minute left. Coach Saul getting his team ready here, and you know, always has his team ready to come out here and play for sure.
Yeah, and you know, Tayshawn Walker for the Scots has been hot. You know, he led them with 22 points in the win versus Albion on Wednesday. So we'll see how the Knights can kind of defend him and kind of guard his hot hand, as well as Connor Riley added 20 points in that victory for the Scots as well. And Riley leads the Scots this season with an average of 18 a game. So we'll see how they can defend Connor Riley and maybe limit that 18 points that he's had so far to this point.
Yeah, I'd really love to see how the Knights come out here. You know, over break, we did see them a lot. I watched them a lot on television, but saw them come out fast, but towards the end they're kind of not able to finish. And, you know, we did see that towards the end of the Hope game. The Hope Flying Dutchmen were actually able to come back in a sense, and I feel like the Knights need to really put this one away early and just continue to keep the foot on the gas.
Yeah, we all know Jalen Overway coming back as a sophomore, All-American as a freshman, been a leading force for this Knight squad, averaging about 19 points per game. Looks like we're going to see Uchenna Ekekeza get his 1,000-point basketball here in a minute, so that'll be cool to see that presentation. But we know that Overway will be someone that they go to here early on, so we'll see how that impact can go.
Yeah, and here we have Uchenna Ekekeza like getting recognized for 1,000 career Uchenna points. For reaching a significant milestone
in Wednesday night's win over home. You know, Ryan, a fantastic career from Uchenna Ekekeza just really represents what the Maroon and Gold stands for night in and night out. Know you're going to get 100% effort out of him, and he's had a fantastic career as a Kelvin Knight, so nobody better to receive that award and that recognition out there at midcourt.
Yeah, what a physical player out there. So fast, so tenacious out there. We always see him going after loose balls, and what a career accomplishment for him. And, you know, he's not done here at Calvin, so big goals for him on the way.
To honor America and those who protect our freedom at home and abroad, please sing along with the playing of our national anthem, which will be performed today by the Calvin Pep Band under the direction of Tiffany Engel. Good afternoon and welcome to the Van Wert Arena here on the campus of Calvin University. Today's game features the Scots from Alma.
Starting
College
lineups coming out here tonight.
And your Calvin University Knights. Let's take a moment to meet today's starting lineups. First for Alma, starting at forward is a 6'2 senior from Almont, Michigan, number 34, Gabe Bordeaux. At forward for the Knights, he's a 6'6" sophomore, the former Warrior from Western Michigan Christian. Number 3, Owen Varnado. For the Scots, starting at center, a 6'7" senior from Lapeer, Michigan, number 32, Colton Meister. At forward for the Knights, 6'6" senior from Wheaton, Illinois, number 20, Marcus Bolt. For the Scots, starting at guard, a 6'1" senior from Landover, Maryland, number 1, Tyshawn Walker. The big man in the middle for the Knights, a 6'10" sophomore from Holland, number 4, Jalen Overway. For the Scots at guard, wearing number 2, a 6'3" junior from Lancaster, California, Nolan Boffman. For the Knights at guard, he's a senior, 6'4" from Huntley, Illinois, number 0, Uchenna Ekekeza. And for the Scots at guard, a 6'3" senior from Blanchard, Michigan, number 23, Connor Riley. And for your Knights at guard, he's a 6'3" sophomore from Caledonia, number 5, Luca Ressler.
And there you have it, folks, the starting lineups.
The head coach for
the Alma
College
Scots, Tyshawn Walker, Nolan Boffman, Connor Riley, Colton Meister, and Gabe Bordeaux. And for the Knights, Uchenna Ekekeza, Owen Varnado, Jalen Overway, Luca Ressler, and Marcus Bolt. Very useful starting lineup here for the Knights.
And you heard there for the Alma Scots, Connor Riley, their leading scorer on the season, averaging 18 a game. So we'll see how the Knights scheme to keep Connor Riley in check and maybe underneath his average of 18 per game, as well as their other weapon, his partner in crime, Tyshawn Walker, who led Alma with 22 points against Albion earlier this week on Wednesday. So we'll see how they can limit those two in their hot hands in this one and kind of keep Alma in check there offensively.
Yeah, very interesting, Ryan, as we go to the center of the court, Overway and Meister in for the tip-off. A loose ball there on the tip-off. Overway sends it back to Paul Uchenna Ekekeza. Now with the ball over to Ressler. Overway at the top of the key. Sends it over to Varnado.
I like this energy from the Alma bench right now, chanting defense and just really pressuring the Knights, making them uncomfortable here to start the ball game.
Bolt posts up underneath. A floater. And that's 2 points for the Knights early on. Huge here get the scoring going.
And I love them getting the basketball to Marcus Bolt early, helping him get into a rhythm and getting some of those other weapons other than Overway established there early on and getting Bolt's shooting touchdown.
And there you have it. Riley now with the ball. Sends it over to Boffman. Arnato on defense back to Riley. Riley going to be a huge player here for the Scots, like we said. Boffman with a shot. No good off the rim, but a block there from Bolt off the layup from Walker. Wrestler up the court now. Sends over to Ekekeza. He loses that for a second. That'll go out on the Scots, so the Knights will have
And some tenacious play right there from Tyshawn Walker at the end to get that offensive rebound right there, admit some trees and go back up and get a shot opportunity, although he missed. And then also another nice hustle play to knock the ball away from Ekekeza down there on the defensive end as well. So good hustle out of Tyshawn Walker for the Scots early on.
Arnato with it, kicks over to Bolt. Chena Ekekeza looking for Bolt. Shot clock low, Bolt from three, just off the rim. Walker with another rebound, carries it up the court for the Scots.
And I like that look there from Bold, although it didn't fall. Had that quick two on the last possession, so just kind of getting into a rhythm there. So I like that shot from Bolt right there in the offense.
Walker slowing things down here for the Scots. Back over to Riley.
And the Knights really rotating well defensively.
And Riley with the floater, first points here for the Scots.
Really nice spin move there by Riley to make Bolt think he was going left and then spin it back to the right hand and a fancy little finish there.
Full court press here from the Scots early on and a foul on Nolan Boffman.
And you know, a quick foul right there, you know, just kind of reaching in, but I like the pressure that the Scots are giving here, picking up full court from the get-go, putting pressure on the ball handlers, a wrestler, and Ekekeza, not allowing the Knights just to be comfortable bringing the ball up the floor.
Yeah, really interesting that the Scots going full court press here. Something that really shut the Knights down in the hope game.
Yeah, and maybe that's something that the coaching staff of the Scots picked up on, is that the Knights struggled a little bit with pressure in that hope game. So if they can kind of just continue to give pressure and not allow the Knights just to get into system and get the ball to Overway easily, which I would imagine would be kind of the strategy here. But after picking up two kind of quick fouls on some of their main ball handlers, we'll see if they'll back off a little bit on the Knights.
Overway with the down low. Looking for options. Kicks out to Bolt. Bolt back into Overway. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Overway to the rim and in.
And if you look at there, just the huge size differential there between Overway and Colin Meister down low. And that might be a little bit too of the reason why the Scots are pressuring, trying to pick up and not allow that ball to get to the block so easily, because Overway is just so powerful there against guys' own size. But with Meister there at 6'7", Overway at 6'10", a 3-inch difference there down the block. So maybe kind of trying to avoid that at all costs.
And on the other end of the floor here, a foul on Varnado. Looks like we're going to be seeing a little bit less of a physical game than we saw on Wednesday. Three early fouls called here, mainly on the reach and really just bodily contact.
Yeah, you know, just a little bit of slow-moving feet, right? A little bit of too much hands, not enough feet, and moving to the spot, beating the offensive player to the spot right there. And, you know, the officials are blowing the whistle and calling that and not allowing things to get too physical.
Looks like we got a stoppage play here. And maybe an issue with the clock.
Yeah, it looks like we have a game clock issue right here, but
looks like we were about 10 seconds too fast there, so about 10 seconds added to the game clock. Scott's now with it here. Riley driving, kicks over to Boffman.
Good help defense there from Bernardo. The slide over there and stop that dribble drive on the baseline. So really nice job there by Owen Bernardo to disrupt that baseline drive for the Scots.
Ekekeza carrying it up the court, trying to drive. He gets in a foul call.
Looks like he'll be at the line shooting two there. I think that was on the shot.
A foul there on Colton Meister. And that was on the shot. Ekekeza able to get a shot off after the foul. Ryan, definitely something to watch here as we end towards the end of the first half is players being in foul trouble.
Yeah, definitely picking up some quick fouls early now, the Scots are. And you know, when you try to pressure and you play with a lot of pressure like the Scots are right now, and that's due to their fact that hoping maybe they can, you know, disrupt that fact that they have a significant size advantage there on Overway, you're going to pick up some cheap fouls. And it's just going to be a point of how long can you continue that pressure, and while you're able to have that pressure, your offense has to pick up and you have to get quick buckets.
Yeah, it also comes down to the depth of both of these benches here tonight. You know, Barnato, Overway, and Ekekeza usually pick up near between 3 and 5 fouls per game. So really looking for that bench of both the Knights and the Scots to be pretty deep. As Walker sends off another shot off the rim once again. Ekekeza driving up, and another foul there on Boffman.
Looks like that's going to be Boffman's second, I believe.
I believe so, too. I mean, he'll have to come out. Like we just said, not even 4 minutes into this one, and 2 fouls for Boffman already. So foul trouble for him already, and really just looking towards the depth of both of these teams.
Yeah, we're going to see how those bench guards for the Scots are able to apply that pressure to the ball handlers, Wrestler, and Ekekeza.
Ekekeza with it on the far side in to Wrestler. Wrestler driving. It gets it stripped away. Barnato trailing. And a nice easy layup there for Connor Riley and the Scots.
Really nice job there by the Scots to transition well and kind of use that speed advantage that they have on the Knights. Although the Knights have the size advantage, I think the Scots look a little bit faster out there on the court. And so kind of taking advantage of that in transition right there is Barnato. This bully ball down there on the block, exactly what you want to see, right?
Yeah, Barnato takes it into the paint. And no kidding with that one, and just straight up on the glass. Wrestler guarding Walker out here on the outside. He sends it over to Meister.
And looks like freshman Jordan Walker is going to be set to check in. And we talked to, or Jordan Scott, excuse me. It looks like he's going to be checking in right here for Wrestler. And man, we talked about his fantastic performance against Hope. Really was a difference maker and part of the reason, if not one of the bigger reasons, why the Knights were able to come out victorious in that one, and just his impact as a freshman.
Yeah, huge game from him as the Scots are able to inbound, trailing 3. Boudreaux throws it off the glass, and Meister able to tip it over Overway. The Scott ends up with the Scott driving, looking from 3, continue to drive, kicks out to Overway, Overway from 3. Bang! Overway!
And I love that patience right there from Jordan Scott, dribbling into pressure with no intent of scoring the basketball, but finding the open man and drawing Overway's defender into help defense, kicking it out, and Overway able to knock down the triple. So fantastic patience there by the freshman after just checking into the ball game.
Yeah, really great there from Overway, especially seeing him really improve his game over the past year and the ability to shoot from the outside, such a dual threat. Barnato up the court, kicks over to Ekekeza, strong up off the rim, and the Knights in transition, up 8 now, and a timeout from the Scots.
And you know, Ekekeza, so good running the lanes in transition, knows exactly where he needs to be. We oftentimes talk about the skills of basketball, shooting, ball handling, all those different things, but one of the little skills that, you know, sometimes gets brushed to the side is how to run the lane and transition, and Uchenna Ekekeza is one of the best at it. He's so strong, he's so physical, and knows where he needs to be in transition, uses his speed and his strength with advantage, as you can see right there, being at the right place at the right time and picking up an easy bucket.
That's something else we really look for, and a lot of the Knights team is being selfless and not looking for the great bucket, or good bucket, but finding the great bucket, and that's what they did right there. You know, Barnato probably has the opportunity to go up there, but kicks over to Ekekeza for just an easy layup there.
And some really nice reads there. Barnato obviously making that right nice read there in transition, drawing the defense, reading whether or not he should take it, whether or not he should pass it up, and he read and made the right decision there. And we talk about Jordan Scott making the right decision there of just dribbling into pressure, drawing the defense, and making Overway's defender slide into help defense and kicking it out to Overway for a triple there. So really nice selfless basketball, back-to-back possessions by the Knights.
Multiple freshmen in here now for the Scots, as it looked like Connor Riley and Scott had an opportunity there, and a layup missed there by Winkle.
You know, the Winkle kind of missed the bunny right there in transition. The Knights still, again, transitioned well and really playing good defense. You know, good defense equals good offense a lot of times. Their defense is fueling their offensive engine right now, and it's something that when that happens on the basketball court, it's really fun to watch.
Yeah, Corbin Heitzman now with the ball, kicks over to Walker. Heitzman, one of those freshmen in for the Scots. Walker drives in, kicks over to number 10, Glenn. Glenn trying to go up against Overway. Ekekeza pressuring and a shot clock violation. Connor Riley trying to throw up a shot there. And really great defense here from the Knights.
Yeah, the Knights are rotating really well off the ball right now defensively. It seems like they're in help defense when they need to be in help defense, and they're rotating well when the ball is passed and moved by the Alma Scots, really just disrupting any offensive motivation that the Scots are getting.
Jordan Scott outside the paint right now, and a nice floater from him just off the front of the rim. And Connor Riley taking it up the court for the Scots, goes up, and Winkle. Foul on him, shooting two now at the rim is Connor Riley.
I like that take there by Riley, taking it to the basket strong. Winkle coming down, clearly, you know, getting a little bit of arm with the ball right there. But the overall good take there in transition by Connor Riley, getting himself to the free throw line.
Yeah, not a bad foul there for Winkle, making Riley really earn the point and not giving him a free layup.
And the foul serves to be worthwhile there as Riley missed the first one of two.
The Knights still up eight right now. Less than 7 minutes of action. Alma Scott's only two buckets so far for them.
And the biggest thing, Ryan, is now is that free throw's good. Is the Scots have 5 points through almost 7 minutes of play. That's just a testament to the defense that these teams, and specifically the Knights, have been playing with through the first 7 minutes. The Knights have defended fantastic through the first 7 minutes of play.
Barnato with it at the top of the key, kicks over to Winkle. Winkle from three, off the back of the rim. Collins gets the rebound, another freshman for the Scots. He gets it over to Riley.
Baseline looks open right now to drive. Let's see if he takes it.
And he does, Overway there to stop it. And a three, no good, but Collins able to get the rebound.
You know, nobody there on the opposite side boxing out. As that rebound just fell right into the hands of Collins there. That's about as easy of a bucket as it comes there for number five.
Winkle getting pressure from Collins. Kicks into Overway. Overway driving, using his body just off the front of the rim. The Knights two in a row missing right off the front of the rim.
And a really good defense there on Overway from Glenn Jr. Disrupted Overway there on the block.
And the Knights here. Scott's coming within three. Would not be surprised if the Knights call a timeout here. Ekekeza kicks over to Scott. Scott driving, blocked off the rim. Overway with a second-hand opportunity.
And I like that crash of the boards right there from Jalen Overway to go get that ball as soon as it was blocked off that layup from Jordan Scott.
Overway already with 7 points, and really you don't notice it, but 1 minute you look up, he has only a few points. Next thing you know, he's in double digits, and just continues to score here for the Knights.
And it's just a matter for the Knights right now of getting the ball into his hands. You know, it seems as it seems with the pressure that the Scots have been giving the Knights, it's been a little bit disruptive in getting the ball into Overway, but every time it gets in his fingertips, it seems to be fine at the bottom of the net right now.
And Scott tries to put up another one, and no good. Riley bringing it up the court. And the Scots cross-court pass from three. The freshman, Collins, hits that one. And Alma Scott's within two now.
You know, Collins saw that little layup go through after he got that offensive rebound, a little hustle play, feeling a quick bucket, and then they're stepping up in rhythm and taking a shot.
And Ekekeza going up strong. The and one for Ekekeza from Scott. Great ball movement there from the Knights. And a lot of substitutions, and we see Bolt, Riemersma, and Wrestler all coming in for the Knights. Varnado, Scott, and Winkle all out. Overway and Ekekeza remain in the game.
And you know, Ryan, with this group out there for the Knights right now, some of their faster, more athletic players out there on the floor with Jalen Overway. So maybe trying to combo with the Scots here and their speed and athleticism out there on the floor and maybe disrupt a little bit of that pressure that they're giving them on the other end.
Yeah, I really agree, Ryan. The Scots getting the better hand of the Knights the past few minutes just with their sheer athletic ability and quickness out there on the court.
Yeah, with Trip Riemersma checked in, one of the most athletic players on this Knights squad. We've seen him drive baseline and have some emphatic jams just getting up there. Looks like his head above the rim at times, so we'll see if his athleticism can play a factor here for the Knights.
Bolt snags the rebound, kicks over to Wrestler, moving up quick in transition. Wrestler slows it down, looking to get into Overway. Back over to Bolt. Bolt gets it to Overway. Overway posting up to just the sheer size differential here. Now double team. Overweight puts it in, and that's something the Scots have got to look out for. You know, Ryan, we saw in the Hope game, the Hope was either double or triple team in Overweight, and finally able to give him some pressure over there. Scott's not doing so, and Overweight finding his way to the bucket very easily. Moore Pierce kicks over to Bordeaux. Bordeaux driving baseline, kicks back to Collins. Collins from three once again, off the back of the rim. Ekekeza with the rebound.
Collins shot that one with some confidence after making two in a row.
And Ekekeza with a fancy backhand finish there.
Anytime that the Knights can get Uchenna Ekekeza driving downhill or just really going downhill and attacking downhill is a good thing for the Knights, as we see there.
And Collins once again with a fadeaway floater, and he's feeling good today. The freshman. The Scots stick with the full court press, Bolt to Wrestler. Wrestler has some space. Back over to Ekekeza. Ekekeza in to, Overway. Overway driving. Puts up a shot. It looked to be fouled.
And we saw a little bit of that double team right there from the Scots we were talking about, Ryan.
And Reimersma goes up as well. Looks like it got a hand on that one. Kicks out to Bolt. Bolt driving. Kicks back over to Ekekeza. Ekekeza no good on the three try. Bolt gets the offensive rebound and in on a very easy layup. Knights back up eight.
And fantastic job right there from Marcus Bolt to get in front and box out and grab that offensive rebound and put it up for a quick two.
Yeah, huge there for the Knights, just tenacity there. Offensive rebound after offensive rebound. Collins once again, shot no good off the rim. Overway with the rebound. No pressure. Kicks over to Wrestler. Wrestler on the far side. Screen from Overway. He gives it over to Overway. Mismatch for Overway. Goes around easily off the glass. Overway in double digits. Knights up 10 now. Moore Pierce has the ball for the Scots at the top of the key. Drives right. Ekekeza helped with Overway underneath. Collins with it. Looks like we got a foul on Wrestler. Barnato and Brady Ewing in for the Knights. Knights put in a freshman of their own.
It's going to be a timeout here.
I believe timeout this time goes to the Knights, really just giving their players out there a rest, especially Overway being in the game full time so far, but already 11 points. The sophomore averaging almost 20 this year. Just huge from the preseason All-American and just making his case known.
Yeah, you know, you talk about Kelvin Knights basketball, probably one of the first names, if not the first name that comes up, is Jalen Overway. You know, you talked about it, the returning All-American here, All-American as a freshman, and has not disappointed in his sophomore season as well, and kind of the guy that when you need a bucket down the stretch, you know you're going to Jalen Overway, this night's group is, and he's just so good, especially just down there on the block, right? He's worked hard to stretch his game out there. He knocked down a three as well. This game is really stretching out and making himself more difficult to defend, and the more tools that he has in his bag as he just continues to grow, and his bag is already very deep. But as he continues to make it deeper and deeper and deeper, and as teams are throwing double teams, triple teams at him, and now his ability just to stretch it out behind the three-point arc, it's just a head-scratcher for an opposing coaching staff when trying to draw up a game plan to stop him, because there really is no stopping him from getting his 15 to 20 every game.
Yeah, no stopping Jalen Overway. The only thing stopping him is taking him out of the game, as the Knights do here to give him a rest. 8 minutes left to play. Collins on the rebound in to Meister. Kicks back to Walker.
And you know, as Walker travels there on the baseline, the Knights have done a really good job of keeping him in check. When he sees a couple go through it, it can be a problem for the opposing team. So the Knights have done well to defend him and not allow him to get the rhythm scoring the basketball here early on.
Bolton Barnato in the backcourt on the full court press. Kicks over to Bolt, back to Wrestler. Wrestler finds Barnato underneath and a hook shot. And first points here early for Barnato. And a big presence underneath, especially when Jalen Overway out of the game. Barnato always able to post up himself. And the Scots trying to drive in on the freshman. No good off the glass. Offensive rebound for Bordeaux. Back over to Collins in the corner. And Ekekeza with a steal up the court. And a two-handed slam from Ekekeza. Just like we saw with 1,000 points. Just getting this Knights team fired up. Knights up 14 now.
And I love that instinct. And one of the things that make Uchenna Ekekeza so special is his ability just to jump a passing lane, predict a pass, and react before it even happens almost there, as we saw him just jump that passing lane and finish with a two-hand emphatic slam.
And the Scots out there, yeah, Uchenna Ekekeza, even with pressure there, is able to go up with a two-handed slam. Most people might be stopping for a jump shot, a jump stop and a layup, or maybe just a layup. Uchenna Ekekeza still with the two-handed slam under pressure.
Yeah, and that's just, he's got some of the intangible things that you can't teach. You can teach someone to become a better shooter. You can teach him to become a better ball handler or defender, but his instincts are what make him so special.
Bolt with another offensive rebound. He's been on the boards today, especially on the offensive side. Wrestler into Ewing. Ewing off the glass, and 2 points here for the freshman. Knights up 16 as the lead continues to expand.
And I love how the Knights are slowing the pace down and getting the shot they want on the block right now and taking advantage of that size differential.
And a foul here on the Knights. Again, Owen Varnado, that'll be, I believe, his second of the game. And he'll have to come out. Dane Harvey in the game along with Jordan Scott. Jalen Overway back in it. Less than a two-minute rest there for Overway, but he's back in looking to make an impact. 6 minutes left in the first half. Scott's inbound, quick shot there from Powell. Rebound from Overway. Bolt taking it up the court. No full court pressure from the Scots. Bolt over to Wrestler. Wrestler trying to get into Overway. And Meister able to jump the pass there. Powell driving, slips. And it looked Scott able to jump in front of that one. Scott hits Wrestler on the near side. Back to Overway. Overway. Two-handed bounce. And in. And one here for Jalen Overway.
And really nice patience there in transition by the Knights. Jordan Scott making the right decision. Cross-court passing. And then Bolt and Wrestler there finding the open men. And then ultimately Overway with a nice little spin finish. There's a little bit of a fancy finish there from Overway to secure the and one.
Yeah, some great ball movement here early on for the Knights. Now up 18. Overway just off the front of the rim there. Not able to put in 13 for him already. Still five left to play in the first. Powell with it now, trying to drive against Wrestler. Kicks it over to Bordeaux. Walker with it now on the top of the key against Scott. Driving. Looks to be a foul on Jordan Scott on the floor. Inbound opportunity here. And you know, Ryan, if you're the Alma Scots, you got to get something going. The Knights been on an absolute tear here early on since Alma made it a two-point ball game. And one. Number 40, Sam Leppin, the sophomore.
Yeah, just getting inside there, getting the contact first, and good focus there to have a finish there and put himself at the line for an and-one opportunity.
And Leppin not able to put in the free throw. Overway with the rebound. Passes over to Jordan Scott. Jordan Scott with the crossover, getting the defender off of him. Kicks over to Jalen Overway. Overway being blistered at the glass. Not able to put it in. Two free throw shots for Overway.
And that's something we've seen a little bit more of here in the latter minutes of the first half, is Overway getting to the line. He's gotten to the free throw line here several times in the past couple of minutes and drawing fouls out there now and getting the Scots into foul trouble.
Overway sinks his first. Another improvement that we've seen this season is Overway with his free throws, sinking a lot more than we did see last year, and just skyrocketing those points, especially with him getting a lot of fouls there in the paint.
And that's not a surprising improvement to see Overway really focus on and make, because he gets to the free throw line so much. I'm sure out of all the nights, I'm sure he's probably there the most, and it might be by a lot that he's there. He spends quite a bit of time at the free throw line, especially in later situations and in important situations and game situations. He finds himself on the line, so important for him to be able to knock him down, which he has so far to this point in the season.
Connor Riley in for the Knights, the Scots, the leading scorer. Looks to be another foul on the floor here for the Knights on Dane Harvey. 1-1 opportunity here for Connor Riley, the leading scorer for the Scots. And only with 7 points here up to this point.
Yeah, the Knights have done a really good job of guarding him as well as Tyshawn Walker, we mentioned. You know, the two most dangerous scoring threats on this Alma Scott squad. So really done a nice job of keeping them in check, and both of them have had hot hands, as we saw them Wednesday at Albion, both significantly there near 20 points.
Another leading scorer here to this game, Donovan Collins for the Scots, up there 7 points, the freshman, just a big impact freshman for the Scots.
And I've loved his confidence. I feel like Donovan Collins has played with good composure and good confidence, not being able to tell that he was a freshman out there. Surprised when I saw that on paper, just rising up for mid-range jump shots, attacking off the dribble, hustle plays. We saw with an offensive rebound and a quick two from him. So I've been really impressed with the play of Donovan Collins, a freshman for the Scots.
Overway with another two there. Knights once again up 18. Leppin passes over to a Scott Walker in the paint. Back over to Leppin. Jump shot no good off the front of the rim. Jordan Scott, triple teamed, able to get the rebound. Bolt up to Winkle. Winkle to Ekekeza. Ekekeza driving out to the corner to Scott. Travel call on Scott. Just under 4 minutes left to play.
Yeah, shuffled the feet a little bit there on the jab step, looking to possibly drive baseline and then kind of just hesitating a little bit there. You know, Jordan Scott, a very talented shooter there. We saw, obviously, in the Hope game, him knock down a couple from behind the arc, so I would like to see him just rise up and take that shot with confidence.
Yeah, I really would have loved to see the confidence there and take a shot, especially up 18, really test your limits there, especially from the corner.
And Tyshawn Walker there with a little spinning try, but unable to capitalize, Ryan.
Yeah, Walker trying to go under the arm of Scott, not able to do so. Scott once again with the ball. Picks over to Winkle. Knights really looking for a good opportunity here in the paint to Overway. Overway spinning, trying to get around. Leppin gets up, blocked by Leppin, but he gets the rebound and puts another one in. 19 for Overway. 3 minutes left to play.
That's just a case of good defense, but better offense, right? Good job there by Leppin to defend Overway, one of the most talented big men in the country there, and picking up a block, but Overway is able to grab it right back and finish it.
Really love the defense and help defense there from Overway. Able to stop Walker driving. Scott up the floor, gets it poked away from Walker, but gets it. Overway from three. Bang, and again, Overway hot from three.
And we talked about his bag of tricks being so deep right there and reaching deep into the bag from beyond the arc there and knocking down his second triple of the night. And Ryan, it's just such a head scratcher, right? Because you have to worry about him on the block, him spinning right, him spinning left, his pump fakes, his step throughs, him doing a reverse. There's so much in his bag to guard down low. And now that he can stretch it out and knock down a triple too, man.
And even if you get the block on Overway, he just grabs it from the air, puts it back in. I mean, cannot stop him without double or triple teaming him. He is just unstoppable against any team. And making it from three, you know, Overway, just hot. He has to have either a double-double or close to a double-double, double-double guaranteed at the end of the game.
Yeah, and we'll be able to confirm that when we get the stat sheet here in a few minutes and get those stats in front of us. But, you know, his hot hand now, the Knights leading 41-18. And we talked, too, about how can the Knights defend and how can they contain the offense of Alma. And we've seen holding Alma to 18 points here through 18 minutes of play. Fantastic defense from the Knights, and I know Coach Saul can be happy with his team's defensive effort and how the Knights' defense is fueling their offense.
Yeah, I really want to see, Ryan, the Knights continue to stay on the gas pedal. You know, it's this point where we see the Knights usually kind of fade out, let the Scots or whatever team they're playing kind of fade back into the game. this is the point where you just put them away and let the reserves come in and finish the game. Riley back out to Leppin. And Uchenna Ekekeza jumps the pass from Collins. Ekekeza up against the rim, lays it off. And another 2 points for him. He's in double digits.
And I talked about it earlier. There's those instincts from Uchenna Ekekeza right there, just able to jump passing lanes, and it's just something you can't teach. And he's so good at it, and he's got a gift there just to be able to read the passing lane and jump out and get a quick steal. As that ball comes up into the booth, got my fingertips on it, but was not able to grab it, Ryan. I'm kind of mad about that.
I think an issue is coming right for us, and then a little deflection out there in the field of play, sending it a little farther down the booth, not able to get a hand on that one, but Ressler now with it. Back over to Ekekeza. Ekekeza and Bolt. Overweight once again driving, triple teamed, is able to get it back out to Bolt. Bolt looking for options, back to Ressler. Ressler to Ekekeza. Knights getting it into Overway.
I like this
Overway
ball
spinning.
Movement.
And another 2 points for Overway. 24 on in the first half.
And I love that ball movement there from the Knights and just feeding that mismatch. And the Alma Scots do not have an answer as Overway is outscoring the Alma Scots entire team right now.
And Overway with some great defense. It looks like that'll be a foul on the floor against Luca Ressler. I believe that'll be his second on the evening. Really got to be careful here not to pick up a third before the beginning of the second half.
And that's going to send the 6'10" sophomore who's tried his best. And we've seen some good defensive moments from Sam Weppin here guarding Overway, but Overway just being super powerful and dominant down there on the block.
Matt Ambrose into the game for Luca Ressler. Sharpshooter from three here, looking to make an impact here late in the first half.
Yeah, Ambrose, the junior, 6'2", 205-pounder, transfer from Indianapolis University, Division II school over there in Indianapolis, Indiana. So we'll see if he can make an impact here for the Knights, and they can feed that hot hand.
Lepian sinks the second, 2-for-2 from the line. Knights able to get it into Winkle. Bolt back over to Ambrose. And the Knights moving the ball well, able to beat the press once again. And it looks like the Scots dropping into a zone defense here, Ryan.
And I'm not surprised by that. As Ambrose right on cue checking in, knocks down that three, Ryan. But I'm not surprised to see the Scots drop into that 2-3 zone. Just another way of doubling Jalen Overway in the front, get two guys up in the front and have that opposite corner guy in the bottom slide in and help defense to kind of get a triple team action, not allowing them to spin middle or right.
Yeah, except if you end up zone, playing a zone defense against these Knights, you're going to end up giving them that opportunity for the three.
Like
Ambrose,
we just saw there with Ambrose.
And a lot of key pieces for the Knights that can sink threes very easily. So both types of defense, very dangerous play against the Knights.
It's almost a pick your poison battle with this team, and that's the reason they're ranked number 4 in the nation, because of their depth and because of how many different weapons they have.
Overway out to Ambrose. Ambrose with another three just off the back of the glass. Knights have the last shot here. Ambrose with it again. He dribbles out to the top of the key. Hands it off to Overway. 10 seconds remain. Ambrose over to Winkle. Winkle driving. Throws up a shot. That's an air ball, just a little too far there. And that'll be the first half. Knights 48, Alma Scots 22.
And you know, Ryan, with that first half coming to a close, my recap is short and it's simple. The Knights played fantastic team basketball. They had the mismatch of Overway down low, and they took advantage and they were able to capitalize. Overway with 26 points going into the second half. So he could just take a seat on the bench right there. He's had himself a day. I'm sure we'll see when the stat sheet's in front of us, him having a double-double, but just fantastic job feeding Overway on the block and really getting the mismatches. And then when getting steals, getting offensive rebounds, getting out in transition, getting the ball to Uchenna Ekekeza and just capitalizing there. We talked about Uchenna Ekekeza's ability to jump passing lanes, a couple of quick buckets off of doing so, but also just running the lane and being in the right spot at the right time. So fantastic job there by the Knights overall, is not only feeding the mismatch and playing team basketball and the defense, fueling that offensive engine, but just doing all of the little things correctly. And I'm super proud, if I'm Coach Saul, of that 22 points going into half, right? Because you can outscore a team and try to get in a shootout battle, but right here, the defense for the Knights has been the factor.
Yeah, the Knights playing great defense, not allowing the Scots to get too many offensive rebounds. Cannot say the same on the other end. The Knights able to get a lot of offensive rebounds as the stat sheet finally comes in over here. And I'm sure we'll see a big game for Jalen Oubre, 10 for 14 from the field. And it looks like we got 9 total rebounds, so one rebound away from a double-double. Nonetheless, we'll see him hit that in the second half.
Yeah, and his efficiency, like you mentioned, 10 of 14 from the field. So fantastic job there of just being efficient with the opportunities that he's been given.
Yeah, a big opportunity here for the Knights to pull away and improve to 6-0 in the conference. Make sure to join us on Wednesday. I believe that one is, let's see, Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. home here in Van Noort Arena, where the Knights take on the Trine Thunder. Huge game for the Knights. 1-2 in the MIAA really could decide the regular season conference.
Yeah, that's going to be a huge game for these Kelvin Knights as the Trine Thunder. Fantastic season this far, and you know that one loss for the Knights earlier in the season, Trine was able to actually beat that team. So we'll see how that matchup plays, and that's going to be a big matchup. But the Knights are playing some very good basketball right now, and excited to see if they can kind of keep that going and keep that rhythm. Obviously, that big win against Hope, hopefully on their way to a big win here, as long as they take care of business in the second half against a very good Alma team. So we'll see if they can keep that rhythm, and a couple really powerful wins right there in conference play moving into that home game with Trine. And so I'm sure it's going to be a good turnout there by Knight Nation against the Trine Thunder at their home floor.
We got about 12 minutes left to halftime. We'll join you in about 9 to 10 minutes to give you a rundown, a little bit more detailed rundown of the stat sheet. But until then, please stick with us, and we'll join you to begin the second half.
They have to score a basket first and then get back to the chair with their own ball. We got some time left. Here we go, cadets. Let's give them a round of applause. All right, we have our first elimination. Here we go, round two. All right, once again, cadets, once the music stops, make your way to a basket, make a basket, and back to the chairs. One make, two makes, three makes. That's the lucky basket over there. Four makes, here we go. And we have our second elimination. Here we go, cadets. That hoop is on fire tonight. There's still time. A race for the chair. Our third elimination. Great job, cadet. And we're back in the middle. One make, two make, three makes. Race for the chair. Our fourth elimination of the night. All right, cadets that are still in, we're getting down to the wire. Down to two. Our fifth elimination of the night. Great job, great job. All right, now there were four. Here we go, cadets. Three chairs to pick from, two hoops remain. This kid picked one hoop, great idea. Got his hoop all to himself. There's still time, there's still time. It's gonna be a race to the chair. Our sixth elimination of the night. Then there were three. Here we go, cadets. What hoop are you gonna pick? Some trickery. There's still time, you can beat him. Oh, and then there were two. Let's give it a round of applause for our two finalists and all the cadets here tonight. Two basketballs, two cadets, two hoops, one chair. Here we go. You say it's too late to make it, but is it too late to try? And in that time that you wasted, all of our bridges burned out. I've wasted my nights, you turned out the lights, now I'm paralyzed. Here it is. We have one make in a race for the chair. We have our winner. Let's give a round of applause to all the Greater Grand Rapids cadets that came out tonight. Great job. Thanks again, Calvin Game Day, for putting on a great halftime event. Enjoy the second half, folks.
Well, welcome back, folks, to Van Noort Arena, home of the Calvin Knights. Tonight, the Knights taking on the Alma Scots. Just a few minutes left of halftime. The Knights up 48-22. Big time lead here for the Knights. Jalen Overway, if you haven't tuned in with us in the first half, already 24 points, 9 rebounds, so needs one more to get the double-double this afternoon. Just a beautiful day here in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Last week we had the snowstorm, kind of some residual snow still left out here, but nonetheless a beautiful day here. A lot of fans coming out here and supporting the Knights, especially coming off the huge win against the Hope Flying Dutchman. Looking for a big second half here, and you know the Knights really struggled with late in the game, trying to put the game away, and this will be a really good opportunity for the Knights here to look for opportunity to put it away and really let the reserves come here and take it away. Really looking for Jalen Overway to take over once again. Be really interested to see if the Scots come out in the zone defense or the man-on-man. Early on, they came out, the Alma Scots came out in the man-on-man defense. Jalen Overway really bullied them underneath with the one-on-one pressure. Later on, switched to the zone defense, but the Knights continue to blister the Scots with some three-point tries, especially Overway with a few from himself. As Ryan joins me here in the booth once again, a minute and 30 seconds left to play in the minute left until we start playing the second half. Here's both teams come here, and Coach Bill Saw coaching up the team. And Ryan, you ready for some second half action?
I can't wait, honestly. I love seeing good basketball, and there's been nothing but good basketball here from the Calvin Knights. They've defended well, they've got to their spots well, and they've just done the intangible things of the game really, really well, and it's been really fun to watch. And, you know, there's been good offense, but even better defense.
Yeah, the Knights really with a lot of great defense here, and a big stat line here. The Knights, 23 total rebounds, 8 of those being offensive, and Alma Scott's only having 13, and that comes down. The Knights are only shooting 58% from the field, but the amount of rebounds that they are getting in second chance opportunity has just really been the difference maker here early on, especially Jalen Overway, maybe not making that first basket, but his height and his tenacity underneath, able to get that rebound and putting it back up for an easy two.
Yeah, and with him here, 24 points going into the start of the second half, a phenomenal stat line for just the game in general, but let alone a half from Overway. But it's like you can stop him once, but you're not going to stop him twice. So,
yeah, it'll be interesting. Like I was telling the viewers at home, it'll be really interesting if the Scots come out in the zone defense or if they stick to the man-on-man that they were looking for at the beginning of the game. One on one end, you're taking away a double or triple team against Overway and allowing him to get in there and have an opportunity to score. On the other end, you're allowing the Knights to take free-range three-pointers, and they're good from out there beyond the arc.
Yeah, Ryan, he's really unstoppable there.
And the Scots inbound here, just kicking things off. Bordeaux looking for options, and the Scots with a turnover coming out of the gate. Knights have the inbound opportunity here. Not what you want to see if you're a Scots fan. Ekekeza into Overway, unguarded out here on the top of the perimeter.
And we see the Scots there applying that pressure that they did early in the first half. So we'll see if they can stay kind of out of foul trouble, which they struggled to do in the first.
And Meister able there to jump a pass, but Overway able to track it down. And regain possession for the Knights. Overway driving, his back turn posting up underneath and falling over. Overway missing the easy bucket underneath. Meister falling over. And just the nerves getting to Overway there.
And he got the look he wanted. He just was not able to capitalize. But overall, getting a good look right there on the first possession. Nothing to hang your head about for the
Knights. I really think Meister falling over really kind of tripped up Jalen Overway. Not really knowing what to do. Varnado from three, just off the front of the rim.
And Varnado there taking that three was hot against Hope from behind the arc there. So we'll see if he can get a couple more looks from back there in the second half.
Scott's here with an offensive rebound. Riley with it. Kicks over to Walker. Walker looking for options. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Regina Ekekeza able to get another steal, but is tripped up from Walker, and that'll be a foul on the floor. Excuse me, that one will go against Boffman, and I believe that's his third of the game, so he'll have to come out once again early on. And once again, Boffman in foul trouble within the first 2 minutes of this one.
Yeah, picked up those first two rather quickly in the first half, and another quick one there to be his third of the game has taken him kind of out of the rhythm of this one, and the Scots have been having to play without him more than they've been able to play with him.
Ekekeza with the ball, kicks into the paint to Overway, Overway out to Ressler. Ressler giving it to Varnado. Varnado cross court to Bolt. Bolt driving baseline, lays it off the glass, just bounces out off the rim. Great ball movement there from the Knights, just Bolt out of the rim. Scott looking to drive is Bordeaux. A foul call there on Bolt. Two shots there for Glenn Jr., the senior out of Macomb, Michigan.
Calvin foul on number 20, Marcus Bolt. It's his first.
Big opportunity, first score of the half. 2 minutes, no scores for both teams.
And with a 26-point lead for the Knights have right now, the Scots are going to have to score a lot of points in rather more of a hurry here in this one. So we'll see if they kind of start trying to get into some faster offensive sets, and the Knights have is going to slow down and take their pace and try to find Overway down low. And so we'll see how that goes.
And Overway still outscoring the entirety of the Scots. Scots drop back into a full court press. Bolt with it now, pressured by Moore Pierce. Knights get it to Overway on the top of the key. Overway over to Ressler on the near side. Ressler into Varnado driving. Varnado over to Bolt. Bolt able to save it, gives it to Overway. 7 on the shot clock. Varnado posting up, kicks out to Ekekeza. Ekekeza from 3. Bang! Ekekeza from 3.
And Ekekeza's been making a huge impact on the offensive end for the Knights here. And in this one, jumping passing lanes, getting those quick finishes. That two-hand flush we saw emphatically earlier on. But they're stretching out from behind the arc and just really scoring the ball in a hurry.
Yeah, Ekekeza not settling with 1,000 points. 14 on the night. Shot there from Moore Pierce, not able to make that one, just off the rim, double doink. Ressler now driving, gives it to Overway. Overway double teamed, looking for options, kicks out to Ressler. Ressler from 3, bang, another 3 for the Knights, and the Knights up 30. Wow.
The Knights really just firing on all cylinders, scoring the basketball from inside and outside and getting a good look, it seems like, every single possession down the floor.
And now the Scots with Walker driving, kicks over to number 10, Glenn Jr. Glenn Jr. back out to Walker. Walker from 3, high arcing shot. And a 3 from Walker brings the Scots back within 27. And a timeout here from the Scots, trying to get anything going here. Really having the opportunity here. There was no scoring for the first 2 minutes, and next thing you know, both teams break out scoring. It seemed like a scoring slump there for a second and an opportunity there.
Yeah, Tyshawn Walker there stepping up with the confidence right there and knocking it down. So he's been one of the impact players we kind of talked about going into this game in our pregame and talked about, you know, really all year for the Alma Scots has been fantastic, especially earlier in the week against Alma, and the Knights have been doing a good job of keeping him in check, but they're hitting a fadeaway 3. So,
yeah, I believe Overway now with the one rebound that he needed there in the first 4 minutes. So I believe Jalen Overway with a double-double. 24 points, no points here in the second half so far. Just had the one opportunity there at the rim, but the Scots kind of seemed to be able to find his kryptonite there for a minute and able to kind of not double-team him per se, but really great help defense here early on from the Scots.
And we'll see if that 3 gives them any rhythm offensively. Now the deficit is equal to the points they've scored to this point, so they need a lot of points in a hurry. So we'll see if Tyshawn Walker can kind of develop a little bit of a hot hand here and shoot his way and shoot the Scots back into the ball game here. But it's going to be a difficult task now with the lead at 27, Ryan.
Bolt with it over to Varnado. The Knights taking their time looking for an opportunity. Varnado hands it off to Ekekeza. Ekekeza double team, gets out of it, goes up against the rim, and a foul call on the Scots. Ekekeza driving strong to the rim. That call on Tyshawn Walker.
Tyshawn Walker, that's his.
That's what he's his second of the game. A bit of foul trouble, but not much for him. Jalen Overway from three. And another one, Jalen Overway, 27 points.
And he's just been on fire from three now. Nine of those 27 from behind the line and behind the stripe. And him just being able to step out there and knock out with a hot shooting day like this is just impossible to defend.
And right there, Connor Riley, therefore the Scots. Oh, gets the bucket over multiple jumping nights. Overway driving underneath. Single team kicks out to Ekekeza. Ekekeza wide open from three. Doesn't go. Varnado gets a tip out. Wrestler picks it up. Kicks over to Varnado. And Varnado with a hard foul there. Looks like that'll be called on number two, Nolan Boffman. And just not his day. That's his fourth on the day.
And Connor Riley there, you know, with a little pump fake action, getting that nice little layup there, making the Knights kind of fly by there. Getting his 11th point of the night. So the first Scott there in double digits is Connor Riley.
Yeah, Connor Riley with double digits, really making his presence known. Overway underneath there, and a block from Tyshawn Walker coming in to help Xavier Glenn Jr., the senior for the Scots. Knights retain possession, 10 seconds left on the shot clock.
Good read there by Tyshawn Walker coming out of help side and deflecting that ball out of the hands of Overway.
Inbound, Wrestler from three. Just too long off the rim. Scots get the rebound there. Scots in transition. Connor Riley going up. Kicks out to Tyshawn Walker. Tyshawn just a bit short on the three.
And a board there by Overway securing that for sure a double-double now.
Yeah, for sure. Now Varnado with it. Looks like Jordan Scott getting ready to check in the ball game. Varnado back into Overway. Overway against two. Gets up and just off the end of the rim. No good from Overway.
You're a little bit too strong right there with a left hand.
And Connor Riley driving baseline and really stacking up some points here for the Scots.
Riley looking like he's getting into a little bit of a rhythm there. So we'll see if now with Walker and Riley both hitting shots, if this Scots offense kind of starts to come alive.
Ekekeza down the near side, kicks over to Varnado. Varnado trying to get into Overway and off of a Scott, so an inbound opportunity here for the Knights. Ewing in for Overway, and Wrestler out for Jordan Scott, the freshman. Let's see if he'll have a better opportunity here in the second half. Scott behind the arc. No good. And once again, Jordan Scott misses from behind the arc. Number two for the Scots, trying to get the lay off the glass. No good. Boffman. No good. Jordan Scott taking up on the far side. Scott being guarded by Tayshawn Walker. Overway with it. Kicks over to Ekekeza. Varnado posting up underneath. Gives it over to Ekekeza. Ekekeza to Ewing. And way too long there from Ewing. No good. And Boffman now with it. Varnado giving him some distance at the top of the key. He hands it off to Glenn Jr., passes over to Tayshawn Walker. He gives up another triple try. Bang!
Basket number one, Tyshawn Walker.
And the Knights turnover on the far side. Ewing tries to give it over to Bolt, and Coach Saul not happy with his team right now.
And I think with Overway checking out, the Knights settling too much for those three-point shots rather than getting into rhythm and setting off the offense and getting inside and attacking downhill, which has worked really well for the Knights for this point and was a reason for that big lead that's expanded to 30 points at times.
You know, Ryan, this is the point of the game where we've talked about it today a lot, is the Knights kind of start to fade away and let the other team come back into this one. Obviously, the Alma Scots down 30. Not very likely that they're going to come back all the way, but for future games, this is where the Knights start to let the other team get back into. This is where they need to keep their foot on the gas pedal and really put the other team away.
Yeah, we'll see what head coach for the Alma Scots, Mike Fitzpatrick, draws up here with now Connor Riley and Tayshawn Walker both hitting a little bit, see if he can get his offense into a rhythm. But yeah, you know, Coach Fitzpatrick in his second season as the head coach of the Alma Scots. Last year, the Scots were 6-19, and the Scots have already surpassed that record here to this point in the season, so definitely playing some good basketball are the Alma Scots.
Ewing playing some defense underneath on Meister, but he's able to get a two-point bucket. Ekekeza over to Bolt.
32, Bolt and Meister.
Scott here on the near side, and a foul call on Tayshawn Walker.
Alma foul on one. Walker, that's his third. team number four.
Third foul there for Walker. Bolt here on the near side looking for Scott. Screen there from Varnado. He tries to go up.
It's a little bit of a surprising no call right there. I thought Varnado might have got fouled there, slapped on the wrist, but the ref saw that one a little bit differently. But nonetheless, I really like that bounce pass from Jordan Scott to lead Varnado to the block to get a good look there nonetheless.
Really love the pick and roll there from the Knights. Really simple, but really effective there, especially in that case, Varnado just not getting the foul call. Akakez on defense. Now Walker guarding. Walker taking it against Scott. Walker looking for another three-point opportunity. Walker off the hand of Winkle. Inbound underneath for the Scots.
Yeah, good help defense there from Winkle. Walker kind of got away from Jordan Scott there a little bit off of that ball screen, that high ball screen, and Winkle was able to pick him up on the baseline and deflect that ball out of bounds. So good help defense there from Winkle.
Walker, another triple try. Bang from him. Wow. Hot hand for the Scots.
And you saw Jordan Scott look over there like, Coach, I had my hand up. There's nothing I could do, which he did. But Walker just getting hot. We talked about him and his hot shooting hand right there as he's hit three in a row.
And Ekekeza trying for a floater, not able to put it up. That'll be a foul on Ekekeza here on the other end. His first on the night, no need to worry. Usually he's up in the fouls and really in foul trouble, not tonight.
And that's Knight's lead that was at 30 at one point and a half is now itching back down to 18. So we'll see if the Knights can get on a rhythm here offensively with Jalen Overway checking back into the ballgame.
Meister with it at the top of the key. Looking for a handoff. And that'll be an offensive foul on Tayshawn Walker.
Ball
I believe that'll be his fourth
four.
On the game.
Team number five.
Walker in a fair amount of foul trouble. 12 minutes left to play in this one. Ekekeza inbounds to Wrestler. Wrestler over to Overway. Overway guarded closely by Meister. Varnado now with it. Looking for a handoff. Passes over to Wrestler. Wrestler back to Varnado. Varnado driving. And a two-handed slam from Varnado.
And you saw that right there. Good job by the Knights to recognize Tayshawn Walker, who's on fire right now offensively, just picked up his fourth foul. He can't play defense. He can't step in front of Varnado right there and risk picking up a cheap foul, driving over and sliding over on the baseline. Varnado knew that. Walker just had to kind of let him fly by and Varnado make him pay it at the rim.
Yeah, great job there from Varnado. Late foul call there, I believe on Ekekeza. That'll be on Wrestler, excuse me. And
foul
more Pierce.
Five, Wrestler, that's his third
excuse me,
person.
Nolan Boffman at the line. Now two Scots with four fouls.
Two free throws.
Boffman and Boffman. Walker.
I can imagine here is Corbin Heitzman, a freshman from Haley, Idaho, is about to check in for the Scots. I can imagine it's going to be for Tayshawn Walker as he's got those four fouls. He really can't defend at this point. And it's going to be just that Tayshawn Walker's going to have to take a seat, which with hitting three threes in a row right there for the Scots and being one of their hottest hands, him and Connor. You know, I don't think they want him to take a seat right now.
Yeah, definitely not the man you want to take a seat, especially with four fouls, not even halfway into the second. Boffman knocks down one from the line, gets a hand on the inbound to Ekekeza.
Boffman in a little bit of foul trouble too, now making his way back on the floor after having to take a seat after picking up, you know, a couple quick ones in the first half and a quick one there in the second half, but, you know, defensive pressure every time he's in, really all over Chen Ekekeza.
Winkle with space, kicks into Overway. Overway, single team underneath. Spin move and in off the glass. 29 for Overway.
Great pivot right there. Faked going middle and just pivoted back and had a wide open right-handed layup there and finished it off the glass.
And a great finish there from Nolan Boffman. Spin it off the glass. Wrestler gets it into Ekekeza. Wrestler into Overway. Overway with one on. Spins once again. Up off the glass. No good. The freshman, Heitzman, able to get the rebound.
Kind of Riley with that spin right there. And I was going to say, Ryan, that he's going to be the hot hand for the Scots,
number
hoping
one,
that he can possibly shoot the Scots back into this game right now with Tayshaun Walker having to take a seat on the bench.
Yeah, he'll have two free throws here, already with 13 in the game, so he's slowly creeping towards that 20-point mark.
Number 23, Connor Riley.
And Riley's found himself at the free throw line a significant amount here in this one, partner.
And no good from Connor Riley on the first. Riemersma in for Winkle. And Bolt in for Varnado. Knights still lead by 19. Knights need to continue. Keep that foot on the gas pedal, Ryan, but really letting the Scots into this one. Lead shrinks to 18 now, as it was 30 just a moment ago.
And still that full court pressure from the Scots.
And Ekekeza gives it into Overway. Overway with 31 on the evening. And Ryan, really not a fan of this full court pressure here from the Scots, as it's given Jalen Overway just easy buckets underneath if you're a Scots fan.
Yeah, if you're gonna pressure full court, pick up full court, you gotta be aware of that slip in the middle right there like Uchenna Ekekeza was just able to do. And when that happens, you're going to get burnt. You're going to have a two-on-one situation with those two who are so good in transition, Ekekeza and Overway.
Donovan Collins.
It's a pick-your-poison
situation. Collins
there
from behind the arc after
Alma calls it fourth.
Uchenna Ekekeza trying to get the steal there and jumping a pass, not able to do so. Leaves a 5-on-4 for the Knights. And number 5, Donovan Collins, the freshman, able to knock down the 3, and that'll get him into double digits himself.
And we talked about Donovan Collins' composure as a freshman. You know, like I said earlier, I was surprised when I looked down at the sheet and he said he was a freshman. So very surprising effort right there out of Donovan.
Yeah, really, really calm and composed out there for being a freshman. You know, taking those shots that you would not see a normal freshman take, especially just really a lot, exuding confidence, and you could tell it's helping the team around him.
And it's helping him, too. He's taking shots with confidence, and that confidence he's taking shots with is helping him be successful.
And, you know, we've talked about him enough, but Jalen Overway, 31 points. Are you kidding me right now?
Yeah, Jalen Overway playing fantastic. He's getting to his spots, and the Knights are able to get him the ball in spots where he can be successful as well.
And Jalen Overway, last week's MI Double Player of the Week, could be seeing another one here this week after this two dominant performances, one against the Hope Flying Dutch, and again here tonight against the Alma Scots. Jordan Scott up the court, passes over in the near side corner to Riemersma. He gets it into Overway. Overway posting up and in off the glass. 33 for Overway now. Connor Riley up the court for the Scots, trying to drive against Ressler. And the Scots having an opportunity here. Travel from Boffman.
And, you know, we've seen a couple of times here from Boffman just trying to play a little bit too quick, you know, especially on the defensive end, trying to get a little bit too up, a little bit too fast, and just everything fast with Boffman. So he's got to kind of slow down a little bit right there and just get to a spot where the Scots can be successful.
Overway driving in, kicks over to Ressler. Ressler with the ball fake and up and off the glass. No good. Overway with two offensive rebounds. He gets the ball taken away from the freshman for the Scots. Riley back up the court driving against Riemersma. Hands it off to Boffman. Boffman off the glass and in.
Nolan Boffman for two.
Bolt to Ressler. Up to Riemersma. Riemersma against one. Kicks over to Jordan Scott. Jordan Scott up off the glass and in.
Jordan Scott.
Believe his first points of the ball game. And a three from Connor Riley, and he's inching towards that 20-point mark. And Bolt with pressure, kicks over to Riemersma. Trap here in the near side. Bolt to Overway, Overway back to Scott. Scott driving now. Out to Riemersma. Riemersma trying to drive, and that'll be a foul call on the freshman Heitzman.
And the Scots are rotating pretty well defensively right there. We saw in that possession with that double trap high, putting the Knights in a little bit of a tricky situation, having to try to get that ball out of that double trap right when they crossed the half court. It's kind of giving the Knights a little bit of fits in terms of setting up in their offense.
Yeah, the Scots definitely not out of this one, even though down 16.
They've done well to claw that lead back down from 30 as well, and kind of a little bit of hot shooting right now as well.
Keza tries to go up strong. No foul call. Reimersma with the offensive rebound. Gets it in to Overway. Overway double teamed and a foul on the floor against the Scots. It'll be against number 20 once again, Corbin Heitzman, the freshman.
Number 20, Heitzman picks up.
And that'll be his second of the game.
Team number 7.
Bolt inbounding for the Knights. 8 minutes left to play. Overway behind the arc. Bang again, Overway.
12 points now from behind the arc on 4 threes. 12 of his 36 coming back from behind the arc. Man, has he just been unstoppable tonight, Ryan. And it's been really fun to watch.
And Overway continuing to inch towards that 40-point mark. And Jordan Scott able to dive on the court there, get the jump ball. And that'll be Knights basketball.
And I love right there, Jordan Scott, the freshman, just diving on the floor, getting after that ball, causing that jump ball right there. Even with the Knights up 19, they're still getting on the floor, doing the little things correctly.
Yeah, for sure, Ryan. Love the energy and tenacity out of the freshman. Reimersma off the court here. It looks like Varnado back in. Bolt inbounding once again, gets it to Varnado. Varnado back to Bolt.
And we'll see if the Scots continue that high trap, and they do not.
And Bolt really just powering his way through into front court.
Looks like it's going to be a 1-1 now, as that's on the Scots, and it is.
Foul on 32, yeah. Meister.
Foul there on 32, Colton Meister, his third of the game. A lot of Scots getting in foul trouble here late in the second.
Now Overway stepping up to the free throw line, looking to add to Artie's impressive total of 36 points here in this one. And, you know, Overway, we mentioned it. He's done a lot of work at knocking down the free throws. Anytime he's there in situations, it seems like he's going 2 for 2, at least getting one at the line.
Overway puts one in, and that'll be 37. Knights lead back up to 20. Really big that the Knights continue to expand that lead, Ryan. It was up to 30, and Scott's able to get it down to around that 14-16 mark, and Knights really clawing back and expanding the lead once again.
And we'll see if now that the Knights are in the bonus every time they get hacked by the Scots, if that'll kind of back up the pressure from these Alma Scots, or if we'll see them continue to pick up full court and be as pressuring on these Knights ball handlers as we've seen to this point in the half.
Connor Riley with it again. Be a foul there on Owen Varnado. A little bit too physical out there, trying to get around the screen. And that'll be his third in the game. A bit of foul trouble for Varnado, but not a huge issue here late in the second.
Yeah, I think he's all right for right now. He can still play aggressive. It's just if he picks up number 4, then we have a problem. And right there on key, looks like he's going to pick up back-to-back number 4. Now we're talking about a little bit of foul trouble picking up 4 here with 7:21 to play. So it looks like he's going to take a seat.
Yeah, Dane Harvey coming into the game now as Varnado picks up 3 and 4 back-to-back.
I'm not a fan of that double foul call right there on Varnado. Varnado's just playing hard, trying to get through a screen. Yes, he was a little bit handsy, but at the end of the day, I think it was clean effort just to get through and to get over that screen.
Yeah, I think it really comes down to adjusting for your officiating crew, and today they've been really calling the physical contact mainly for fouls and just really adjusting. And, you know, Coach Saul in an earlier interview said that the Knights, that's what they need to work on, is Overway goes up strong there. Number 32, Meister almost with the block there, but a lot of body contact. And Overway Meister at the line once again, that'll be his fourth. So 3 Scots at 4 fouls and foul trouble, still 7 minutes left to play. So a lot of things that could happen here and could be seeing a lot of players off the bench for the Scots.
Yeah, nice job by Meister, too, to knock down that elbow jumper in that last possession.
Overway not able to sink the first. Scots within 19 right now. And Overway hits the second. He's up to 39. And the lead grows to 20. Tayshawn Walker carrying up the court over to Connor Riley.
With Tayshawn Walker now back in the game after picking up his fourth foul, we'll see if the Scots go to him and see if he can continue that hot shooting. He hit 3 in a row from behind the arc before he had to check out due to foul trouble.
Dane Harvey, the defensive specialist here, in on Connor Riley, not allowing him to get in there.
and it's all one-sided right there for the Scots. You see that? It was back to maybe the middle, back to the left, and Tayshawn Walker's over there clapping his hands. I'm open, swing it to me on the wing. And when you stay on that one-sided, it makes it really easy to defend like the Knights did right there well, because you're not having to rotate cross-court.
Colton Meister there coming out of the game in for number 40, Sam Lepien. Bolt now with it. Great physicality there from Jordan Scott, able to get the ball for the Knights. Overway in on the glass and one. Up strong. An and one opportunity here for Overway.
As he passes into now the 40 mark, 41 points in the game and an opportunity to make it more here at the stripe after the and one. Just been a fun, fantastic basketball game to watch Jalen Overway play basketball today. It's just been a privilege.
As the bench erupts after that and one opportunity, let's see if he can sink it here. And he puts in the free throw now, up to 43 on the afternoon. Just all-time high here for Jalen Overway and counting.
And you know, Ryan, what I love about that, yes, Jalen Overway has 42 points, and he's played a little bit of bully ball tonight. But at the end of the day, it's been from outside. 12 of those 42 points have been from behind the arc. He's gotten to the free throw line. He's extended with some elbow jumpers. He's done some fancy footwork down low. He's gotten second chance offensive rebounds. He's just really done it all tonight. It's been really fun to watch.
Overway driving back out to Scott. Gets it back into Overway. Overway posting up. And he spins off the glass, and it rolls out there. Connor Riley driving, kicks out to Powell. No good from three. Overway with another rebound. Kicks over to George Scott. George Scott driving against Powell. George Scott driving. Foul call against Powell.
And you know, Ryan, with Jalen Overway now surpassing the 40-point mark. It's the first 40-point-plus basketball game in Calvin's men's basketball player has had since Chris Knuster had 41 back in 1993. And we see here Jalen Overway has already surpassed 41, but it's been a little bit of time since a Calvin men's hoopsters surpassed the 40 mark. So it's been since 1993, so it's been a minute. So we're seeing a little bit of Calvin men's basketball history here out there on the court tonight for the Knights.
Looks like we got four substitutions here for the Knights. Overway off, and Coach Saul coaching them up, and that'll do it for the game for Overway. 42 points and an all-time high for Jalen Overway. What a game. As Ekekeza fires him up over there on the bench. Jordan Scott remains. Matt Ambrose in the game along with number 21, Josh Elliott. Or excuse me, 21, Michael Morris, Brady Ewing, and Trevin Winkle. Connor Riley in for the Scots, driving it down the court. Looking to drive, lays it up off the glass. Too hard, no good. Trevin Winkle with the rebound, kicks it over to Ambrose.
Ambrose had a hot shooting hand in the first half, so maybe look for him to get spotted up to capitalize from behind the arc.
Ambrose looking for an option, driving. Kicks over, looking for Winkle. And number 40, Lepien, is able to jump the pass. Boffman lays it in for the Scots. Just under 5 minutes left to play. Ambrose almost getting trapped there, able to find Winkle on the near side. And Ewing coming in off the baseline, lays it in there. Great ball movement here from the Knights reserve. Connor Riley now with it here on the near side, guarded by Winkle. Help defense there from Ewing. No good from Lepien. Winkle carrying it up for the Knights. Ewing now with it over to Jordan Scott. Scott trying to drive. Pick from Ewing. Ewing was open. Scott pulls up with a floater. No good.
I like that mid-range jump shot from Jordan Scott. So good from the mid-range is Jordan Scott. And so a good look right there nonetheless.
And there, Boffman able to lay it in once again. Being really careful there with four fouls and really making his difference known on the offensive end. The Knights still lead by 22, but the Knights call a timeout to talk things over and try to get some things straightened out here on the defensive end.
You know, Ryan, might not have been a close game here, at least to this point. the Knights jumped out to a big lead early and have been able to kind of maintain that lead. But, man, how fun was it to watch Jalen Oberway here make some history with that 40-point game, the first 40-point game since 1993 when Chris Knuster did it with 41. But Oberway scoring 42 tonight, it was just really fun to watch. Great basketball.
Yeah, great basketball from Oberway. The hot hand from three-point, and the Scots really could do nothing to guard him underneath in the paint. It looks like we got number 34, Mitchell Cook, in the game here for the Knights. And a foul on number 30, Logan Van Essen, the Knights, here to shoot two.
Foul on number 20.
Yeah, two. Double bonus here for the Knights. Foul call on number 20 for the Scots, Corbin Heitzman, the freshman. Van Essen, shoot two. And the first one in for Van Essen, the junior out of Crown Point, Indiana. And in and out there for Van Essen. An offensive board for number 21, Mitchell Morris, for the Knights. And he'll have two shots at the line as well as he gets fouled on the offensive
foul
rebound.
Two,
Knights up to 80 points. Lead stretches to 23. Gabe Dirksen looking to check in here for the Knights. Brady Ewing comes out. And a big game filling in for Jalen Oberway there towards the end of the first and second halves for him.
Yeah, got himself a couple of buckets, played well, played good defense, rebounded well. Overall, good showing there.
And in for Michael Morris, the sophomore out of Grand Rapids. And the second try is good as well. Just under 4 minutes left to play in this one. The Knights' lead is 25. Connor Riley up the floor. Looking for options. Guarded by Van Essen. Up on the glass and an and-one opportunity for Connor Riley.
Connor Riley just so skilled there. You saw him cross over between the legs, spin move, pump fake, pivot, and still be able to maintain focus and knock down that shot, kissed off, smooth off the glass, and get to the line for the end one opportunity there. So Connor Riley's really impressed me tonight with just his overall basketball skill.
Yeah, Riley from the line. No good on the free throw. Knights able to get the rebound. Van Essen, Cook now with it.
Yeah, Riley with 19 here tonight too.
Cook hands it off to Van Essen. Van Essen driving, kicks out to number 24, Dirksen, just off the rim. Rebound there for Morris, and he puts it in. Great offensive rebound there for Morris. And the Knights reserve looking no signs of slowing down here.
And you love to see the effort and the energy coming out, and just the Knights bench here as excited as Morris was when he got that offensive rebound in that bucket. So really love to see it and love to see just the overall camaraderie with this group.
And Morris looking for an opportunity from three. Morris now driving, a jump stop. No good on put back, and the loose ball over here on the end. It wasn't sure who had it. Now number 14 for the Scots. Smith with it, lays it off the glass and in. Dirksen to Scott. Scott handed it off. Number 30, Van Essen. And now Dirksen from three, bang! And the bench is fired up as the Knights' lead grows to 26 on the night. And a backdoor pass for the Scots. Almost able to lay it in is Judson. Scott drives it down the court. Coach Saul calls a timeout there. Number two, DJ Potts-Hurd, the sophomore, able to get in, as well as number 35, Hank Goldcool, the senior from Traverse City, Michigan. Potts-Hurd in to Mitchell Cook. Botsford now with it, looking for options. Kicks back over to Dirksen. Dirksen driving, fadeaway jumper just off the front of the rim. Gade for the Scots. Kicks over, 21, Elliott. Elliott driving, poked away there from the senior, Goldpool. Botsford over to Dirksen. And now with it is Cook. Cook driving. Looks to go up, and I don't know what that, no call on anything there as Cook goes down. An attempted three try there from number 14, Rashad Smith. No good, no rim. Botsford inbounds to Cook. Cook with it. Gets it in to Goldpool. Goldpool driving the baseline and steps out on the baseline. Minute left to play. Scott's inbound. Rashad Smith, the freshman from Flint, Michigan. He gives it over. Sam Lepian. Lepian looking for options over Paul Gade. Scott's looking for options. Knights playing some great defense. Goldpool with it now. Gives it up to Cook. Cook driving it.
An emphatic slam.
Oh, my goodness.
An emphatic alley-oop finish there by DJ Botsford.
And Botsford with almost a steal there gets the whole gym fired up after that one. 89-61. The Knights leading. And the Scots able to put that one in. Knights here might just dribble this one out. Cook now with it. And they will. Cook giving the alley-oop to Potsherd. What a slam. Way to get the crowd going towards the end of that one.
And the Georgia native getting up and throwing that one down with two hands. Man, was this an exciting, fun basketball game around for the Knights. Man, it was fun. Jalen Overway scoring 40. DJ Botsford getting up there on the rim and finishing with two hands. The Knights, of course, taking care of business here, 89-63.
Yeah, huge game here from the Knights and Jalen Overway. A career-high game. Nothing you could say that hot from three, can't stop him underneath. You can't do anything to stop Jalen Overway today. And really just great here from the Knights and really leading this team to victory here tonight.
Yeah, you know it, Ryan, and stay tuned, right, audience? You're going to be interviewing here and talking to Coach Saul. Should be a pretty fun interview after a win like this here tonight, as, you know, Overway making some history and the Knights taking care of business just really from the start in this one.
Yeah, as we have the stat sheet, Jalen Overway finishes with 13 total rebounds, 42 points, and 3 assists. Huge game from him, double-double. And career-high, first 40-plus game since 1993.
Yeah, and, you know, Overway played really, really well tonight, but another guy that just really stands out, not only on paper, but stood out in watching this game tonight was Uchenna Ekekezi. You know, being honored on the middle court for 1,000 points, but having 14 in addition tonight as well as just getting some steals, playing fantastic defense and getting out and running the lanes well and just doing a lot of the little things right.
Dirksen and Ambrose, 3 apiece. Jalen Overway, 42. Congratulations, Jalen. Upcoming games, the Knights will host Trine.
Hey, Coach, emphatic victory here today. Jalen Overway, the star player of the game, 42, 13 rebounds. What do you got to say?
Yeah, he had a great game. Did a lot of really good things, you know, a little surprising. It's got to be about the first time he's had a game in forever that I didn't come on a double, which just kind of blows me away. But if they're not going to, man, we're going to just do what we do. And he did a great job. You know, he hit some threes today, which was awesome. I mean, he can shoot those. Yeah, just an efficient basketball game by him. And, you know, I mean, it's one of those things in a game like this. I thought we really came out a lot of energy to start the game. I thought that, you know, you always get worried a little bit about that hangover going into after a big Hope win. And, you know, I think we didn't do that. But You know, when you get into a situation the second half, you know, I'm always, man, we gotta grind it out. And we just didn't quite get to where I wanted us to go. But overall, it was really great to get a lot of these guys in the bench time. You know, those guys sacrifice so much every game, every day. They work so hard. And, you know, I'm just happy we could reward them with getting a chance to go out there and play. And did some pretty cool things, so that was kind of fun to watch.
Yeah, for sure. You know, you talked about it for a second. But what did you say to the guys, you know, the Scots able to come within that 16 up 30, you know, what did you say to get the guys back going and get back fired up?
Nah, just do what you got to do, right? I mean, you're going to have some runs here and there. I mean, yeah, I mean, if you're up 30 and get it to 8, then you have concerns. But 16, let's hold serve. Let's get it back to where we should have it. And I thought we did that.
And one more for you, Coach. You know, you said the reserves, DJ able to get the alley up and really get the whole arena excited. But, you know, what do you got to say about, you know, the reserves coming in? And it really didn't seem like the mood changed at all. And it seemed like the intensity stayed the same out there on the court.
It was really good, right? I mean, like I said, those guys really do a lot of things. I mean, Mike Morris comes in and he's in there for, you know, 3 minutes, gets 2 free throws, gets a rebound. I mean, a hustle points. You know, everybody that got out there contributed, and that's the thing. I mean, we've got a lot of depth. We have a lot of guys that are on this roster, right, that there's a lot of Division III teams that they could play on. But, you know, they elected to come here to Calvin and be a part of something special. So, you know, like I said, I just feel so good that we could reward them and get them a chance to go out there and do some things.
Yeah, thank you, Coach. Congratulations on the huge win, and good luck.
Hey, thanks so much.
And, you know, Ryan, we heard it right there, allowing the reserves there to get an opportunity, rewarding them for all the hard work they do. And, wow, they put on a show.
Absolutely. You just see the talent from the top guys, as Jalen Overway scoring 42 tonight, but even some of the guys that don't get to play or not, catching up there, getting everyone, you know, off onto their feet there with that alley-oop. But it's just, that's what makes this team so special. One of the reasons why they're ranked so highly in the entire nation is it's just that depth, that next guy up mentality, that there's so many guys that Coach Saul can trust that can go in and contribute night in and night out, and there's just so many different weapons. You know, it was kind of Jalen Overway's night, but, you know, it can also be Ekekezi's night, Bernardo's night. It can really be anyone's night, and so there's so many contributors on this squad, and that just makes him a really just head-scratcher for opposing coaches.
Yeah, a big game for a lot of guys here tonight, but Jalen Overway takes the cake. And I really love what Coach Saul there said. You know, get within 16, that's so what, get within 8 there. I love how much of trust he has in his guys to get back out there, do your thing. I love that.
Yeah, and it just comes down to, you know, he's a fantastic basketball coach. Right, he coaches them well, he prepares them well, he prepares them for game situations, and that's why these Knights don't overreact when the pressure's on, because the coaching staff's already prepared them for it. And that's something that, when you've already been prepared for a situation, you've already been there in a hypothetical practice situation, it makes it a lot easier when they're there in a game. So credit to Coach Saul and the entirety of the coaching staff.
Yeah, huge game from the Knights here today. Make sure to tune back with us in Wednesday, 7:30 against the Trine Thunder. Huge MIAA implications. But if I don't have anything, you don't have anything more to say. But Ryan, we hope you have a great day, and stay safe out there. God bless. And Ryan, signing off.